What's the cutest date you've ever been on? Took the first girl I loved to climb a hiking trail. The week prior, I scoped the place out with my friends and made sure I knew where to go, etc. At the top, there was this big stone building that you could climb up with an outstanding view of Boston. So I brought her up close to sunset, packed dinner with all of her favorite foods for a picnic, climbed up that building at the top, and watched the sunset over Boston. Very romantic, 100% free, 10/10 would do again. I kept this date a complete surprise from her, besides telling her to wear sneakers and comfy clothes, and she said it was the most romantic date she had ever been on. Then she cheated on me a few months later. Cut. I took my now wife to Steak and Shake for the first time, then drove her out in my truck to a cornfield in the middle of nowhere to see the stars and lightning bugs coming from the field. She's an LA girl and had never seen stars or that many lightning bugs before. Seeing her face light up when I walked her to the field and she looked up and saw all those stars was the moment I fell deeply in love with her. And then a wave of lightning bugs came out of the corn and she gasped and had this huge smile and I fell even harder. It was absolutely adorable. We then went back to Steak back quote and Shake to get shakes. I still take her out to the darkest areas I can find to see the stars. Her face still lights up as soon as she looks up. I've never seen anything that beautiful in my life. I end up staring at her more than the stars. We went to a botanical garden and geeked out over all the cool plants they had. God damn, I miss that ex. Walked around the zoo, started to downpour. Everyone left except us, and we kept on walking around soaking wet. I told him how romantic it was that he shut down the whole zoo for our date. Then we went home and banged. Loved him. It was super cute. He knew I liked period costumes, so for our third date he took me to an after-hours museum event, the theme of which was the Roaring Twenties. For a few days before the event, we planned our costumes over text, and he showed lots of enthusiasm, even though I'm sure it was boring for him. I remember that he joked, "Well, you know what they say about the third date, costumes." He took me to the roof, where we chatted and had drinks, and then he asked me to be exclusive. Afterward we went inside, and walked to a catwalk that was suspended over the main hall of the museum and he asked me to dance. The following year, we had our engagement photos taken there, and the photographer asked him to dip me, while on the catwalk and he nearly passed out. For whatever reason, he had asked me to dance that night on the catwalk despite a profound terror of heights. Our first Valentine's date, I bought a ton of glow sticks, a small stereo system and my laptop, to school to set up for our after school date. We were in high school. Thing is, I can't set up shit and be on a date at the same time. I had my bud secretly set up everything I bought for the date as me and her were eating. I scouted a pavilion at a riverside park. I had them set up the glow sticks in a path leading to it, ending in a heart in the center of the pavilion with my laptop playing a playlist of our songs. After our meal we went for a walk in the park and oh what do you know, hey look lights. And away we went. We danced for like 10 to 15 minutes before we got cold. I gave my buddies $20 for pizza. They are the real MVPs of that date. An all-day date. Back when I was in high school I had a crush on this guy for a few months, and he finally asked me out. Texted me the night before, and was like, "Hey, I have rowing later in the day. Can we do a movie at like 10 a.m? I was totally fine with it, so that was our plan. He came, picked me up, and we saw the movie. After the fact he looked at me, and told me, that he wanted to blow off the rest of his plans for the day, and spend it with me. The second activity was bowling, which I'm atrocious at. I told him this, and he said that he was super good at bowling, and maybe it would rub off on me, which I said maybe I'd be lucky this time. So every time we would take our turns, after his he would make a big show of wiping off his body, and rolling all of his luck into a ball, and throwing it to me. It was actually the best I've ever bowled. From there we went to dinner, and then went to every dock around the lake that we live on. On the final dock, we were skipping rocks and he kissed me. It was my first kiss, and I was literally shaking, excited and nervous. It wasn't anything super special, but I'll always remember it. Met up for Greek food. In 10 minutes I had realized that I had never met anyone like her. Interesting, interested, smart as a whip, funny, and gorgeous. We ended up hanging out for the next 6 hours, just walking around, eventually going to her buddy's shop, where I met her friends, who were all cool. The next date we ended up hanging out for most of the night, and neither of us wanted to drive home, so we set up a hammock in a park and fell asleep. I still have a picture of her head poking out of the hammock, the next morning with the sun rising behind her, making her smile glow even more. She even said that my chest was like a perfect pillow, which really meant a lot to me. Coming up on our 1 year. Me and my love were very poor one Christmas. She is a huge Walking Dead fan. This was back when Walking Dead was a very odd show. So I bought a Walking Dead themed gingerbread kit. We made an apocalyptic gingerbread house and zombie nativity. It was fun, and all we could afford that year. We were supposed to go to this really fancy French restaurant, and then to a concert at the Symphony Hall, and then, I got super sick, and couldn't stop vomiting, and was running a fever of 102, barely able to move, with muscle cramps all over my body. So I told him I couldn't make it, and when I, super embarrassed, explained why, he asked me if there was anything I needed. About 15 minutes later, he showed up, then helped me get undressed, absolutely nothing sexual at all, and picked me up, and laid me in the bathtub, and he ran me a cold bath with bubbles and ice. Then, he set up a laptop on a step stool, so that I could watch Harry Potter with him. He had a pillow, while soaking. He held a bucket for me, and whenever I needed it, he would hold it, so that I could throw up, and then he would empty it into the toilet, and spray some essential oil so there wouldn't be a smell. And, he brought me ginger ale, locally made. We were there for about 4 hours, and I started to fall asleep, as my stomach had finally been emptied. He helped me up, dried me off, and helped me get my pajamas on, and carried me to bed, where he tucked me in, and left a bucket by the bed, and got me a big glass of ice water. When I apologized, he told me that he had had fun, that it wasn't my fault I was sick, and to call him if I needed anything in the morning. Not still with him, relationship never even really went anywhere, but that was just the best date ever. I went on a date with a guy I'd met online. When we saw each other, right away we both knew it wasn't going to work out. We were at dinner and I said, "Hey, I'm not really feeling any sparks here, but I do really enjoy your company. You feel like going for a drive?" And he said he wasn't either, but he enjoyed my company too. He grew up in the city and I grew up in the country, so I knew some awesome spots, and he let me drive. We ended up driving 1.5 hours northwest to this gorgeous clear pond. There's no light pollution and you're surrounded by mountains and pine trees, so the sky over the pond kind of looks like a planetarium. It's in rural Maine, so we have all kinds of wildlife. I keep camp chairs in my vehicle, so I grabbed a couple and a blanket from the truck and set us up nicely on the shore. We stayed there talking all night, and watched the sunrise. It was really cool, because there were like 5 different owls, 2 above our heads, just chatting so loud for over 2 hours. There were loons too, and a deer drinking from the water only about 50 feet from us. We didn't talk again after that day, but I'll always cherish that as my favorite date experience. I went on a date with a girl, and she had a funny hobby of browsing Craigslist personals, mainly misread connections. We had a good time. I showed her the city as she hadn't really ever been. We had been texting a lot for weeks, and got along great. I made an ad with an inside joke and she texted me, "OMG you didn't." I was very happy, and then she said she started dating someone else, and advised that I should have kissed her on the end of the first date cause not doing so wasn't bold enough. I still disagree. The second date is the physical date. It proves they actually like you, and aren't being polite. Here I am, 2 years later and still single as a Pringle. Taking my grandma out for Valentine's Day though, so that should be lit. Your second date logic is flawed, my dude. You just gotta go with the flow, while uncertainty is still in the air. I've kissed at the end of one of my best first dates ever and got ghosted, and then onish date I've done the same, and we ended up going through a Trojan 3-pack. Dating is cruel af. The day I got proposed to, we had saved up to celebrate 6 years together, and went on a trip to Hawaii. We wanted to go on our 4-year anniversary, but we couldn't afford it whatsoever. He took me to the beach, and we had a picnic, while watching the sunset, and drinking out of coconuts. As time went on, and I was full of one too many lukewarm sandwiches, He rolled over to my towel and asked if I wanted to marry him. I said yes, and then we went out to a very nice restaurant and proceeded to eat two platters of seafood and shrimp cocktail, which is going to be served at our wedding because I'm a Dyson around shrimp. Also, another cute date we went on was for my birthday last year, and he took me to see alligators, which are one of my favorite animals. I mentioned it like once, but he remembered. We even got to see baby ones.